a story, and we pull all of our science experiments from the story. Since it's so close to St. Patrick's Day, we decided to do this story, How to Catch a Leprechaun. So I know there's probably tons of you out there that have read this already, that are familiar with this one, but beyond making the leprechaun traps, we are going to talk about how to lure your leprechaun. Because the leprechaun's not just going to go in your trap, but we need to entice them. We need to have some bait in there. So there's two things that we're going to do. One is we're going to learn two different ways that we can use stuff that's around your house. So if you're at home right now, you can use these things to make rainbows that are going to call your leprechaun over, kind of like a bat call, kind of like a reason for them to come over. And next thing that we're going to do is we are going to demonstrate how we can turn ordinary pennies into gold coins.
One way we're gonna attract the leprechauns is creating our own rainbow. And what we're going to use is a white piece of paper. You could have a white countertop or a white floor. We're gonna use a clear glass of water and a light source. In our case, we're using a mobile phone. If it's sunny out, you can use that, or if you have a flashlight. And we're gonna use the dispersion of light to create a rainbow. And very simply, you're just gonna shine the light source from one side through the glass of water, and it and you'll see a rainbow form on the other side. Because what's happening is when the light passes through the glass and the water, it bends. This is known as refraction. So different properties causes the light to bend differently. This is why there's a refractive index. And each wavelength, which corresponds to the color, bends differently. So you'll see certain colors that bend sharply and others that bend less sharp. And so you'll form a rainbow and you'll see certain colors that are on top of the rainbow and others that are on the bottom part of the rainbow. So which colors tend to be on the top and which ones tend to be on the bottom?
So here's another way that you can make a rainbow at home to attract your leprechaun. So you're going to use just a couple of things that you have around. You can use a small cup with just a tiny bit of water at the bottom. We're going to have a paper towel that's cut so it will fit and stand up in your cup. And then just markers. So markers that are dark work pretty well. I have a dark blue, a brown, purple, pink, black. And what you can do to make this really interesting is to even look for different brands of markers and see how it works differently with the different brands, as well as different types of markers. This is a whiteboard marker, and you can compare and see what happens with different types of markers and with different brands. So all you do to do this is you cut it a little bit so it stands up like this, depending on the size of your cup, and then you'll fold it in half, and fold it in half again until you'll have three folds in here. Now the bottommost fold, you will go ahead and just draw like a dark line on it. So what we're going to do is you are going to go ahead and drop it in, and you're not going to move it once you drop it in, but you're just going to prop it up so it sticks out a little bit. And you want to make sure the water in there does not, it's low enough that it doesn't touch where the line is with the marker. So I'm going to go ahead and drop it in here, and we can observe and see, like it's falling a little. What's happening, you can see it starting to come up. I'm going to do a couple other ones too. So here I'm going to have my purple. So something that helps is if you kind of fold it like this and put it in, that helps it stand up a little bit better. And then this one, do our brown one. You can see how quickly it starts working. This is our black one. So even within just a couple seconds, it looks like they're starting to move up. Here's our original one again. So that was the dark blue. And you can see the color is starting to be pulled out of the original color and starting to make a rainbow type of look. So these ones are still working. Let me show you some, because if you leave them, it looks like this now, but they actually keep going. So this is one we had made with purple. So this one ended up like this. This is our pink. So we have this pink one. This is how, actually maybe I'll let you guess what color this one is. This is black. So all of these colors were pulled out of the original black color. And I don't know if anyone could guess. Can you guess what color this started with? This one is brown. So it started as brown and it pulled all these different colors out of it.
For the second rainbow, what we did was known as chromatography. And I used to do this in my forensic science class, and it was known as ink chromatography. And what we used was chromatography paper, the chromatography vial, and some sort of solvent. And it's not normally water. In our case, we used water as a solvent. And what happens is the marker, and if you use different brands of black marker or black pens, you'll notice that the colors that come up are actually different. They're not exactly the same. And what happens here is because all these different pigments are used to create that color black or the color purple and all of that. And when you put it in the solvent, in this case water, water's gonna come up because water interacts with itself, which is known as cohesion, and also interacts with other things. And in this case, there's different fibers. So there's cellulose within the paper towel, and it's interacting with that and is coming up through adhesion. And in addition, it's also taking what is soluble. So the different components interact with water differently. So as you can see, the blue is more soluble in water than the red that's at the bottom. And because of that, you'll have this different profile. And this in forensic science is known as the retention value, and we calculate that. But through capillary action, water is coming up and it's taking the different components and it's being separated into a rainbow.
So before we make our trap, we're going to talk about different kinds of bait we can make. So think about what are some things that we could put right by our trap to attract our leprechaun. Maybe we make a four-leaf clover, maybe you could draw some shiny gold coins, maybe a certain kind of food. We're going to show you how to make something else, but think about what you can make to add to your trap.
What we're going to do now is create leprechaun bait. So how do you think we could attract these leprechauns? Do you think we could attract them using a pot of pennies? Probably not. But what if we could turn these pot of pennies into a pot of silver pennies? So we turn these ordinary pennies into silver pennies, which unfortunately you won't be able to do at home. We use chemical plating, and we plated this with zinc, and we put these in a strong base solution. So we used a sodium hydroxide solution to coat just ordinary pennies to look like they're silver, into these silver pennies. But do you think the silver pennies gonna attract the leprechauns? Most likely not. So what if we could turn these into gold pennies? Don't try this at home, but the way we're gonna turn these into gold pennies is we're gonna use a flame. Have our penny here, and we're gonna turn these gold. Unfortunately, it's not real gold. This is known as leprechaun's gold or fool's gold. It's actually brass, which is an alloy of the copper that's on the penny and the zinc that we use to coat the penny.
So anytime before we start reading, we always take a look at the cover because this gives us clues about what we're about to read and it helps us predict what the story might be about. So as I'm looking at this, I see there's all these little plants and I wonder why these look different. I wonder what those plants might be called. And I also notice there's someone running away and I wonder, why does he have these funny socks? He has some green and white striped socks. He has some pointy shoes. I wonder who this person might be. So the name of this one is How to Catch a Leprechaun. And I notice, wow, it has all of these clovers also in the inside. So how to catch a leprechaun. So as we're looking at this, it looks really dark, but I wonder, this must be the leprechaun, I'm guessing. I wonder why he's the only thing that's a different color. The night is dark, the streets are quiet, St. Patrick's Day is near. I tap my hammer so you'll know the leprechaun is here. So this one is a rhyming story, and if you're just starting to read, like sometimes it helps if we pause and we can take a guess about what that last word would be. Look, he burst out of the house. You'll never catch this leprechaun, impossible, that's a fact. Unless one day a brilliant child designs the perfect trap. How would they catch him? But who will that child be? Okay, everyone's working really hard to figure out what kind of trap could you make. So it looks like first they're drawing out their ideas. So they each have different ideas and they're talking to each other to think how they might catch him. Says, better luck next year. We learned all these ways we can lure our leprechaun. We made two kinds of rainbows, we made gold coins, but once he's here, what can you make to trap the leprechaun? So we are going to have a challenge. And what I want everyone to do, we're going to talk about how you might make your own leprechaun trap at home. And then once you do that, it would be a lot of fun if we could all post our ideas on our Facebook page or our Instagram so we can see what everyone's made. So the way you can do this, typically we go around our house and we just find different things that we have. So I was going around and I found a cup, found popsicle sticks, I found some string and rubber bands and found clothespins I thought would be interesting, some paper clips and even this fruit basket. I also have a coffee filter and I wanted one sheet of paper. So part of what this is identifying how you might use something in a different way. Like maybe you see something and it inspires you to make something else. So there's a couple ways you can do this. You could collect all your things and then start to design and think about how your leprechaun might work. To make this even more challenging, you could give yourself a limit. Maybe you're only allowed to use 5 things. So once you gather a lot of things that are really interesting, you could see if you could only use 5 different things that you might use. These are just cut up sheets. To make it. So you would just pick 5 things and design your own trap. So this is what we're going to leave you with for today. So I want to see everyone going. You will probably have completely different supplies. It doesn't matter what kind of supplies you use, but just kind of coming up with an idea and thinking about how you might make a trap. And then go ahead and post this on our Facebook or Instagram so we can see what everyone's been working on.